After 9 days of testimony and 38 witnesses called to the stand, the prosecution in the George Zimmerman trial rested its case. So did these key witnesses help or hurt? Joining us for a fair and balanced debate, Jonna Spilboard, defense attorney David Schwartz, former prosecutor. Welcome to both of you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Jonna, you say the prosecution has done a great job at the wrong thing. What does that mean?
The prosecution in this case has done a great job of proving reasonable doubt, which is ironic and funny because that's not the prosecution's job.
How did they do that?
But you know how they did it? They have rested. The defense, after 9 days, the prosecution has rested. If the jury had to make a decision today, if the defense did not put on a single witness, I think the jury has to come back with an acquittal because the state did not prove guilt beyond a reasonable doubt on a murder two charge. They just didn't do it.
You agree, David?
I agree with that assessment, but there's a lot more to this. As a prosecutor, you got to find ways to pull it out. You don't pick your witnesses from central casting. So the key here is to negate the self-defense. I think you give up on the murder, and now you have the lesser included manslaughter. That's what no one's talking about here. The manslaughter, the culpable negligence, this reckless type of manslaughter. And you can prove, based on those facts in this case, that this could be a manslaughter.
But they would have to ignore the whole theory of self-defense in order to get to manslaughter. And you can't ignore it. I think the prosecution has proven the defense's self-defense claim.
Yeah, I'm not sure about that. You know, I don't think that's been disproven. I think under this theory that I have, look, the murder's out the window. I agree with John 100%.
And can they pivot now? I mean, even though he's been charged with murder, can they change it to
the lower? Absolutely, because under Florida law, the manslaughter is a lesser included. It's automatic. So you just have to request that from the judge. I believe that's going to happen in this case. They negate the manslaughter, the self-defense, and then we'll be stuck with a manslaughter, which could be interesting.
Jonna, do you put George Zimmerman on the stand?
You know, I say no way, and we don't have to put him on the stand now because there were three videotaped or audio confessions, admissions by George Zimmerman that the state put into evidence for him. And he was not subject to cross-examination by doing it that way, but in those three audio tapes or videotapes, he basically lays out a perfect self-defense claim. Why risk putting him on the stand and be subject to cross-examination? Because you never know what's going to happen. It's not necessary.
I'm not sure this is perfect self-defense claim. I mean, Zimmerman was pursuing Trayvon that night. There was a fight that broke out. I'm not sure, based on any of the evidence, it shows that
based on the head
himself.
Injuries, based on the broken nose,
these weren't serious head injuries.
The big argument is who is screaming on the 911 tape?
You've got to use reasonable force to protect yourself.
Right,
it doesn't mean taking out a gun and shooting Trayvon. So I do believe we may have a manslaughter here, but the prosecution has to come to play at summations, and they got to put this all together and show the jury how reckless Zimmerman was acting that night.
Do you think that it matters that there was contradictory assessment of who was screaming on the 911 tape by the moms?
I think that will, what we call in the law, will be a wash. Because right now we have two mothers. We have two mothers, one saying it's my son, the other one saying it's her son. The jury's going to have to disregard that. And when the jury disregards any evidence, that is a point in favor of the defense.
Absolutely.
Because the defense only needs to prove reasonable doubt.
David, we've heard your theory. You think that they are going to go for the lesser included charge of manslaughter. What do you think the outcome will be at this point?
I don't think the jury can ignore self-defense. And if you find that Zimmerman acted in self-defense, then you don't get to the manslaughter. You only get to the manslaughter if you're compromising in a way that you shouldn't be compromising on the law.
And let me amend that. I think that's the prosecution's only chance is the manslaughter. I don't think the jury necessarily is going to come back with a manslaughter, but I think if they're going to win this case, that's the charge they have to go with.
David Schwartz, Jonna Spilboard, thanks so much
thanks
for the debate.
Great
to see you guys. All right, an important